Hello, welcome back, finally, to the Legend of Heroes 3 Song of the Ocean Let's Play. Thanks for tuning back in. I usually don't show this screen in the beginning of the video, but look at the date of the last save, October 29th, 2022. That's when I think that was the last one I played before I came down with Bell's palsy, which put me out of action for over a year, and then, well, actually, a year. 3 weeks short of a year, and then I was just struggling to find out where to put this, because I had downsized my channel a little bit and taken out two alternating Let's Plays. So, back to here, but try to bear with me a little bit. I don't remember what's going on. I know, of course, we're on Riatom Island. We sailed over here, I'm pretty sure. There's some kind of festival, or it's actually a ceremony about to begin. And this area, we just explored all of it. Pretty sure. So, when does this festival begin? And I seem to... Yeah. I haven't used this gamepad in a while. It doesn't like to go down. It's like left, right, up, down. There's a hesitation there. Sometimes worse than others. So. Okay. So the ceremony, where are we supposed to be going? Is it on the next screen? I think it might be back where it came from. My memory's a little spotty here. Alright, I think it's back where it came from then. I figured it was happening here, but... Well, it probably will be. We just have to start it, right? But I wanted to look around first. And that's kind of what happened there. You know me. Okay. Whoever wants to start this ceremony, we can begin whenever you like. I'm not reading these things out loud because I probably already read them. Next 3 days, huh? Tomorrow's audition. Are we supposed to go to bed so we can get to the ceremony? Possibly up here, then? Oh. No one hanging around up here, is there? Empty chest. Okay. No one's in there. It's him again. Did I look in here? There's probably someone we have to talk to. Okay. Just looking for anyone with an exclamation mark over their head. Oh. Forte says, let's take a nap for a little while. I think that's what it was supposed to be. We're supposed to come back and take a nap. And then the ceremony will... begin? Maybe not. I don't know why, but I always sleep on my stomach. Well, I don't think that was it. I think think that was just a standard sleep, not a plot-driven sleep. Good at deceiving people, huh? I always think of Grayskull when I see that. A three-way battle. The opening ceremony will be starting soon. Rish will give his speech to the audience. Master Rish. In the main building. When? In a moment, in the lobby of the main building. Straight north. That's where we came from. What starts off Mr. Rish doing his thing? I don't remember this part. It's been so long. Oh, yes. Alright, let's see if we can... what we can do about Master Rish, then? That's the one who's... we're not allowed in his room. Yeah, to the north. Aha! Was this the building I was just in? Is this a different building? He's waiting in the lobby. This is a different building. Never mind. So, yeah, this was a smaller building. Oh, the kitchen. Doesn't look like a kitchen to me. I'm just looking around. Re-familiarizing myself. You're back a few pounds heavier. Right, you're a girl. Okay. And then what's through here? Outside? Oh. Back to them. All three of them. Alright. Well, I love purple, so we'll talk to the purple-haired girl first. Oh, that's not even a girl. Argus says, are you also contestants? We represent the Shanoon tribe. McBain says, it's a tribe inhabiting the desert in Austern. They have traditional art handed down through generations of tribespeople. How come you know so much, Grandpa? Our strength is that we not only play music, but also dance. We enchant both the eyes and ears of the audience with our alluring dance and melodies. That's the distinctive style of the Shanoon tribe art. Forte, I guess, whispering, they may be our strongest competition. Enchant both the eyes and ears of audience with alluring dance and melody. That's distinctive. Yeah, I think you said that before. Okay. And you... Quechua? My name is Quechua Shanun. Oh, bless you. I am a Shanun tribe dancer. You must be performers, too. Una says, we are the McBain Company. It's nice to meet you. I've never seen the ocean before, says Quechua. It's really huge. It's like a gigantic oasis. Alright, and then this is Rish, I suppose? Oh no, it's Mayor Holstow. I am Holstow, the mayor of Ekyul. Pleased to meet you. Una says, pleased to meet you too. Forte asks, Grandpa, where is Ekyul? It's located in the western part of Marcheres. The city is famous for huge ancient cedars. Ekyul dolls carved from those cedars are loved by people around the world. Actually, my childhood friend is a master craftsman of the folk craft. Mayor says, would you happen to be a friend of Grandpa Rosette's? Yes, as a matter of fact. How is he? He's fine. Full of energy, I should say. Ekyul is a nice place. It's smaller than Cavaro, but the weather is mild and the pace is relaxing. Please drop by during your tour. Who are these hooligans? Miss Marito says, please don't follow me. I have no interest in a man whose eyes sparkle when he hears the word casino. Mayor DeMille says, we were both called to the lobby. I must go this way too. I don't want to be with a tomboy like you either. You seem to be the type who kicks men's asses. Awesome. Such vulgar language, says Mr. Maritos. Wendy, let's go. We shouldn't waste our time on ribald guys like him. Diva Wendy says, President Maritos? DeMille says, she's always rude. Let's go, Balthazar. Who says, Mayor, you are a bit childish there. I miss this music. Awesome. Okay. Now we must speak with all of them. Okay. It doesn't want to go down. Diva Wendy says, you're also here for the audition? I'm Wendy. Pleased to meet you. Wendy, says McBain. The top billing Diva Wendy of Cavara? You're as beautiful as how they described you to be. You must have an angel's voice. I'm flattered. The bad blood between the President of Maritos and Mayor DeMille is famous in Cavaro. If they truly care about Cavaro, they should try to get along with each other. Miss Maritos says, you must be the McBain Company. Bruce told me about you. Bruce, says Forte. Who's Bruce? Una says, oh, Bruce the Entertainment Manager. Oh, from way back, right? In the beginning, sort of? Like the first concert we did, I think we met him. Correct me if I'm wrong. McBain says, so you must be the head of the Maritos group. Hello, nice to meet you. Ryutam Island is a perfect place to develop tourism. It has mild tropical climate and abundant seafood. The island is conveniently located and can be accessed from both Muth and Polka. You have a place called Polka? They play polka music there? We'll make money developing a resort here. Rish is a disgusting guy, but as a businesswoman, I must admit that his enterprising spirit is first class. Mayor DeMille, nice to see you. My name is DeMille. I'm the mayor of Cavaro. Forte says, Cavaro is the place where the International Theater is. Rish tried to buy the theater once, and the people of Cavaro developed an ingrained dislike of him ever since. McBain asked, and how come you're attending this party, Mayor? Well, that's because I couldn't overcome the temptation of red and black. Forte says, the temptation of red and black? Not only did I lose to the temptation of red and black, I also failed to resist the lure of 21. Okay. So we're talking... I forget. Not the slots, but I'm thinking of the wheel that you spin, and then the lure of 21 is blackjack. I know how you feel, says McBain. So you know. Alright, so we'll talk to Rish, I'm assuming. Oh no, it's Balthazar. My name is Sid Balthazar. I'm a pianist from Cavaro. Pleased to meet you. I know your name, says McBain. They call you the Magician of Piano. The Magician of Piano, says Forte. What a cool moniker. Please, don't. I'm still a greenhorn. Mayor DeMille is competing against the president of the Meritors group. Since the president nominated Wendy, the mayor brought me as her competition. And now more people enter. Forte says, hey, it's Gareno. I don't remember these people. Okay, well, he walked in. He doesn't have a exclamation mark. Only one of them does, but I'm going to talk to all of them anyway. I'm looking forward to the audition, Boreon says. Miss Ruptia, I remember her. The mansion is very grand. The loud, flashy decorations are not to my taste, though. Principal Forgin says, this place is warm and comfortable. It's a fantastic place for an old guy like me. Oh, we saw him in one of the other rooms, he said that. I hope the next 3 days will be fruitful ones for all of us. Let's see if they have anything new to say now that these people came in. Nope. Nope. I've never seen the ocean before. It's really huge. It's like a gigantic oasis. She probably said that already, right? Okay. Ambassador Gareno says, oh, you've arrived. No, we were already here. You've arrived. Forte says, we decided to enter the audition. Now that you're in, I can't wait for the audition. We are still waiting for my colleague to arrive. Rish? McBain says, your colleague? A diplomat named Slade will be sent from Burrodane. Oh, okay. He should have arrived a long time ago. Maybe he will arrive now. Oh, no, it's Merchant. Oh, that's Rish? Merchant Rish says, ladies and gentlemen, pleased to meet you. Welcome to the party to celebrate the completion of my mansion. I am Rish, the unscrupulous merchant whose name is known to the world. Why would he call himself unscrupulous? Forte says, he just introduced himself as the unscrupulous merchant. It must be a joke, said McBain. Well, the world of business is cutthroat. For merchants, working hard means beating others to get ahead. Literally? In that sense, I'm a die-hard, unscrupulous merchant. If they want to call me unscrupulous, so be it. On the contrary, I'm happy that they loathe me as a greedy businessman because it means I have successfully realized my belief. Knowing how the general public feels about me, I didn't build my house in any country. Until now. Seeing you, distinguished ladies and gentlemen of the elite society gathered here celebrating the completion of my house, I have changed my mind. People are reaching out for someone like me, a person loathed by the world. The world is not a bad place at all. I am truly grateful. As a token of my appreciation to you, I shall entertain you to the best of my abilities and resources. Please enjoy yourself to the fullest on Riotam Island for the next 3 days. Hey, back here. Forte says, I'm surprised. He's not as bad as we thought he would be. Gareno says, I was also surprised myself when I saw him. He is not a bad person at all. How do you know? He sat there and talked for like a minute. However, I am not without my concerns. Concerns? Says Una. McBain, will you come to my room later on? I need to talk to you about something. Alright. I'll come to see you later. I'm staying in the VIP room in the back. I'll see you then. Well, we're coming with him. Forte says, so what should we do now? We have plenty of time, says Una. Forte says, we can practice on the stage. Una says, or we can stroll around on the island. Ready on that. Or we can gamble in the casino, says McBain. Forte says, Grandpa, we are not here to gamble. We promised Elise that we would play Forest and Sea Memory. We must practice hard. McBain says, we must remember to visit Gareno in his room later. Okay. The first class musicians are playing. You have finest food and a sophisticated casino. We'll have so much fun here. Miss Riptia? Same thing. Mayor DeMille says, the ball slides around the wooden frame and dances over the numbers, making those dry sounds. Oh, how sinful are those sounds. I'm a captive of the game. Principal Forgeon says, about forest and tree memory and sea memory, what does trees mean? Una says, right, we don't see any trees around here. Leon F. Richter was a genius. He may have meant something else. Trees and beaches. I wonder what those words mean. Driftwood, basically. Okay, now what do we do? Oops. A scene is unfolding. Ambassador Bereger says, Ambassador Gareno, how are you? Oh, I am thoroughly enjoying the tropical weather. Bereger says, I must thank Rish for inviting me to this paradise. I see Diplomat Slade has not arrived yet. No, not yet. He is simply taking too long, and I'm worried. He may have been caught in an accident or something. I see. Well, I haven't met Diplomat Slade, so I came to offer my greetings. In fact, Gareno says, I don't know him personally either. Being away from my home country, I can't keep myself updated on the personnel rotations. Haha, don't complain. I have things to do, so please excuse me. Psst. Tells him not to complain. And then just takes off. Gareno says, oh, thank you for coming. Forte says, who is the person you were just talking to? He is Ambassador Bereger from the Numeros Empire. Do they like numbers? Please, have seats. There's no seats here. McBain says, you said that you wanted to talk to us about something. What happened? Well, I noticed a few strange things. Strange things, says Una. First, the soldiers from the Principality of Pensola, who was sent to help with the party, are nowhere to be found. Oh, I know why, says Forte. Forte explained what had happened to the Principality of Pensola. That's so. I heard about the cancellation by the Duke of Pensola, the main guest, but I didn't know the story behind it. I see. That's why Rish is quickly building his relationship with Ambassador Bereger. Una says, Ambassador Bereger, the person you were talking to just now. Yes, he's from the Numeros Empire. We've been over this. Grandpa, where is Numeros? It's located southwest of Weltluna. If I remember correctly, Numeros is bordering Burrowdane. Say that 5 times fast, bordering Burrowdane. The Numeros Empire is accelerating its militarization lately, Gareno says. Rumors have it that they are getting financial backings from Rish. McBain says, Rish was a parasite on Pensola. Now that he has lost his host, he is trying to strengthen his ties with the military power of Numeros. I think that's what it is. Gareno says, I have one other thing I feel uneasy about. It's getting a little rough here. Many of my guests invited to the party are from Graysoul and Marcheros. You're right, says McBain. It's strange. Both countries have been publicly critical of Rish. Una says, is there any country that supports Rish? Gareno says, the Numeros Empire. But Ambassador Bereger is the only guest from Numeros. It's really strange, says Forte. You think so too? That's why I want to see Diplomat Slade as soon as possible and hear about my homeland and its neighboring countries. Oh, maybe, says Una. Forte says, what is it, Una? Diplomat Slade, right? He may have been caught by Rish already for learning some secret between the Numerush Empire and Rish. Gareno says, hey, Una, don't scare me. It's a leap of imagination. I don't think that's the case. She's probably right. Contrary to what he said, Ambassador Gareno looked uneasy. At any rate, I now know why the soldiers of Pensola went back. McBain says all we can do is to wait for Diplomat Slade to arrive. Well, we should be going now. Have to start practicing our performance if we want to put on a decent show at the audition. Gareno says, good luck to you at the audition. I'll be cheering you on. Thank you, Gareno, Una says. Woof. Anything else to say? The audition will be a neck-to-neck battle, but I'm sure you will emerge victorious. There are many great performers, but you're the only group who can fix seasick with your performance. Good luck with your audition tomorrow. Now that's his private room? Now what? Is there anyone in this room? No. Same. Okay. It doesn't want to move going down or south. What do we do now? Are we supposed to go practice? McBain did mention that. Wow. Oh, I've been over here, right? Oh, yeah. Hidden casino. Should we try to gamble or something? And talk to him from across the table. I don't bet against a child. Don't take it personally. McBain is with us. He'll do the betting. Ugh. These people are lamers. Oh, is this what's his name? Oh no, Brion, never mind. Okay. Mayor DeMille says the ball rolls and rolls, drawing sexy curves. A sensual contrast of red and black. Roulettes are truly the stars of any casino. That's it, the roulette wheel, that's what I was thinking of. Well, I'll bet 50 coins on Rouge. The dealer turned the roulette. It's 17 noir. No. It's a big responsibility to be the mayor of Cavaro. Recently, I've been busy negotiating with the Meritos group over the management rights to the International Theater. I know the lady president, says Una. She's a female version of Rish. I had no idea I would see her at this party. I can't relax now. Can't even talk to them because they won't answer from across the table. Scallop mousse and white wine sauce. I don't think we can actually buy it. Alright, now what? Let's go practice over here. McBain says, we only have today to practice. We have decided on the piece, but we haven't practiced forest and sea memory too much yet. Let us begin immediately. Okay. Someone's clapping. It's the lead chef. You guys are so talented. It's great. We're not sure yet, says Forte. It was perfect. You played it so well, Leon would be satisfied. So you know this piece, says McBain. The chef says, I was born on Rio Tom Island. It was the lullaby I grew up with. My name is Roland. Nice to meet you. I'm in charge of all meals for you and other guests. Believe it or not, I'm the lead chef. I think we got that idea. At such a young age, says McBain, you must be talented yourself. We look forward to your delicious meals. You can count on it. Forte says, hey, somebody told us about the chef from Rio Tom Island. That's right, says Una. The captain of the ferry told us on our way here. His brother was hired for the party as a chef. You know my brother? Forte says, yes, we performed Forest and Sea Memory on the Grumble, and he was very pleased. McBain says, he was curious why you agreed to cook for Rish, a person you hate so much. He said that he wanted you to quit the job and come back. I think he was joking, though. It's so, my brother. I didn't take this job for nothing. Actually, I have an idea. By the way, says Una, Elise was also from this island. Well, what about this guy's idea? She took care of us right after we arrived. Roland says, we grew up together. Did she give you a tour of the island? Yeah, she did. She seems to really love Rio Tom Island. Yeah. But this is not Rio Tom Island anymore. It's just a place with a bunch of rocks. Rish ruined the island to build his mansion. Roland put on a vexed face. My break is over. I should get back to the kitchen. I must prepare for the dinner, you know. You must be busy, says Forte. We have so many people to feed, but we only have the apprentice chef and myself in the kitchen. Things are really hectic around here. When the Pensola soldiers were here, I could use their help. Una says, is there anything we can do to help? You're short of hand, right? Thank you for the offer, but I can't let the guests work for me. But you can relay my message to Elise. I couldn't find her at the reception desk. That's an easy job, says McBain. Are you sure? Please give her this. They receive note from Roland. Well, says McBain. 10 bags of flour, 1 gallon of butter, 6 packs of spice. What's this? Supplies we need. It's a grocery. It's a shopping list. What do you think? If we don't get hold of these ingredients, nobody will be eating at the party on the boat scheduled for the last day. I want to ask my brother to get them for me. Una says, Forte, it's strange. Why are they short of flour? They took all the flour and forced the bakeries to close. Roland says, Rish is a miser. This party looks lavish, but we are actually short of supplies and we're having problems. Of course, I'll have to show you the real skill of a good chef sometime and cook up something using only limited ingredients. Anyway, please give it to her. Forte says, I don't feel right. McBain says, where has all the flour gone? Una says, we should find Elise first. We must give her the note. Why don't you feel right? So... Oh, it, like, skipped like that. It just says, note. Note Roland asked to give to Elise. Order for food items short on stock. Okay. So we gotta look for Elise. We will do that next episode. Hopefully the competition will be on, because we're gonna have an extra long episode. Special 50th episode. And our welcome back to the Legend of Heroes world. So... be anywhere between an hour and a half to 2.5 hours, something like that. Extra long episode. Hope you enjoy. Hope to see you there. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.